In Miami, the fans gather, 60,000 of them, to fill the Orange Bowl and see Georgia Tech and Kansas fight it out. The engineers build themselves plenty of yardage on this run back with an extra 15 tacked on for a clipping penalty. A few plays later, Jim Still, Tech quarterback, heaves a long one right down there into the end zone where Patton makes it 6 points for Georgia. The Jayhawkers from Kansas bounce right back with Bill Hogan pitching the pigskin to teammate Bud French for a nice game. And then, on the next play, Ray Evans carries the mail to make it a tie ball game at halftime. Tech 7, Kansas 7. The second half gives Jim Still plenty of time to prove his passing ability. Bill Queen grabs this one, and Kansas stops him with a new twist. But with the same combination operating, Still to Queen, this time it clicks without interruption. He's still at it. Still, he passes him dizzy. Broadnax gets under this one. Under the next for another touchdown is Jim Patton, and Georgia Tech wins 20-14. 47,000 chill fans at Dallas, Texas see Southern Methodist spark plug Doak Walker get going against Penn State in the Cotton Bowl Classic. It's all Walker right now. Stopped on the ground, he dazzles Penn State with some fancy stepping before getting rid of the ball. And when he does, it's a long one and neatly snared by Page, who tucks it in and skids over for the game's first touchdown. The Mustangs keep the initiative in the second period with McKissick hitting Penn State for long gains. He picks up 20 yards this trip, a hard man to bring down, and local rooters go wild. On the next play, it's Walker again, over for SMU's second touchdown. The score is now 13-0, and time for Penn State to get going to stay in the game. And they do. Petchel sparks a renewed Penn State surge and chalks up a badly needed first down around the Mustang flank. And a few plays later, it's Mr. Petchel again, passing this time, and a beauty too, right into the waiting arms of Larry Cooney, who goes the route to put Penn State back in the game with a bang. Forced a kick from behind their goal line in the third period, the Mustangs meet Mr. Petchel once again. Much to their consternation and chagrin, he takes this bowl football seriously. Petrol again, and a 13-13 tie in the Cotton Bowl as Triplett scores. In New Orleans, it's the Sugar Bowl, and a sweet football game, and some sweet passing by Bobby Lane of Texas. Lane tosses one to Pyle as the Longhorns start their stampede of Alabama's Crimson Tide. When the Texas aerialist sets up shop for one of his deadly passes, trouble brews for Alabama. Blount snares it, and the game is on in earnest. The Crimson Tide changes on this exchange of kicks. The Longhorns kick to Alabama's Mosley, who juggles it around a bit before he settles down to the serious business of running it back, which he does, too, quite handsomely. Bama's touchdown is a Lulu, with Gilmore on the passing end and White on the, stealing end. And it ties things up 7-7 at the half. The second half is all Texas. Steers fell on Alabama. A punt is blocked. In the ensuing scramble, everybody gets in the act. But Vasicek of Texas ends up with the ball, and there are 6 more points for the Longhorns. Another break for Texas comes when Gilmore fades for a pass. He spots a receiver all right, but not right for Alabama. Holder intercepts, and the Longhorns go on to win 27-7. Pasadena's annual football pageant draws 93,000 to watch Michigan's Big Nine champions tackle Southern California. Elliott gets away for the Wolverines and racks up 18 yards before Southern Cal can pull him down. Michigan won the first Rose Bowl contest 46 years ago, and with Bob Chappius passing, they're heavy favorites to repeat. Rivenberg's lateral to Hill Keene completes the play, and once again, Chappius sparks a performance that picks up 7 yards and sets Michigan up practically on the dotted line. On the next play, Weisenberger plunges over for the first score, and the Wolverine steamroller is on its way. Southern Cal has nothing to stop Chappius' throwing arm, and another pass finds its mark in the waiting arms of Mann. Just to show he's not fooling, Chappius shoots one to Yurgis, and once again, the cards are stacked against the Trojans. A short buck by Weisenberger does the job, and scoreless USC watches helplessly while the Michigan total mops, and that man Chappius rifles another down to Elliott, who weaves his way down the field for a neat 28 yards before they toss him. It's Michigan's big day and Chappius' big moment. His heave to Yerges is good for another marker, and it all winds up Michigan 49, Southern Cal nothing.